I'm Whitney Jones and I live in Rogers, Arkansas. I have three boys, and ever since the boys' dad and I divorced, I have always known that I wanted a place where the family is gonna come. It's where my kids will come. It's where their kids are gonna come and learn to grow and laugh together.
So tell us about the house. You just bought it.
It's got great bones, and there's so much more potential. The backyard's totally unusable. It's a steep mountain, and inside, there are a lot of do-it-yourself projects gone wrong.
It's kind of rushed.
And after living in it a few months, it became more and more apparent that the house just wasn't designed the way I would like it to be designed.
Oh, I absolutely love my mom. And when you walk in now, like, it just kind of feels dull and gray, and it's not my mom.
Oh, you guys.
Is that a galvanized pipe?
It's galvanized. You can see the joints where it's put together. There is a giant pipe right in the middle of this dead space. This could be really bad because we may not be able to do one big walk-in closet. Did you see anything on the roof?
There's a vent out here.
Yeah, there is a pipe out here.
Hey, wiggle that pipe.
Oh, yeah, that's it.
This pipe goes to nowhere.
They must have removed the fireplace before Whitney bought the house, and then they just covered it over and left it.
What are you guys gonna do? Wiggle the pipe some more?
We're gonna pull it out. All right, we're gonna try to get it out of there. I think I can just pull it out.
Well, he got the first 2 feet off.
All right,
it's out of my hands.
There you go. I'm gonna take her over to the trash can real quick.
We got more room for the closet now, man.
I mean, you look at that, that's 2 feet of space right back to the closet. All right, let's get all this stuff out of here.
This is nice, and then you go to the steep hill of doom.
A little dangerous.
We have got to figure out a way to make this backyard accessible for Whitney. This is obviously the best part of this house, is the view, but it is so steep back here that we have got to figure out a way to make it actually functional. So, I think that there's a couple things we have to do. One, we have to like make a tiered deck situation so they can have a grill and have a sitting area. So we'll redo the upper deck outside her bedroom to bring the railing up to code and make it a place where she can read a book or enjoy her morning coffee. But then the one thing she really wanted was a fire pit area for her boys. So it's like we're gonna have to terrace this somehow.
So what if the deck ends somewhere in here?
You step down from the screened-in porch, you go into a nice big deck, a little outdoor kitchen where she can grill. Yeah, that could work. And maybe it's something that we could close so it is not open to the elements all the time. Like, she can close it up when they're not using it. And then you'll step down onto a terraced flat area where we'll have a fire pit, a place where her boys can have their beer. It's like just a nice space for her and her family to relax and enjoy the view of the lake.
Here we go.
Here we go.
I have no idea what to expect.
May I slow down a little bit?
No. Deep breath. Oh my gosh. Are you kidding me? Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh.
Good to see you.
Good to see you.
Oh, I love it. Wasn't anything I expected.
We went with the shake siding here. I really wanted it to feel like a cozy lake cottage.
Yes.
Then you have the white trim just to make it really clean and make it pop. We also brought the stairs around so you can kind of approach either way, and also a new front door, the wood door, and added some landscaping, but kept it super easy to maintain.
Yes, that's what I love, easy to maintain.
Oh my.
Can you believe that?
No. Oh my gosh, it's gorgeous.
You can go in.
I got no words. Oh, two sinks. Oh, yay.
I don't understand how this happened.
So in this kitchen, you know, you had non-functioning drawers and doors, and it didn't flow well. You had the peninsula. So, I mean, this island is massive. There's tons of storage. And the black counters, this honed granite, because I know you like kind of that neutral, masculine design,
I do.
Right? And then the wood, you know, just that natural feel. And you're up here in the trees. You want some of that in your kitchen.
Oh, it's got doors.
Wow.
Oh, and they put a bar in.
I love it.
Oh my gosh.
And bench seating.
I felt like this window needed a window seat. There's storage in it. You can lift it up. We had a cushion made for it, so you can take that off and store all your things in there.
Have coffee, and look at the lake.
Yes.
Oh my gosh,
awesome.
I love it.
Yes.
Oh my gosh, look. It's a fireplace with a mantle for stockings.
Look, it's stained.
It's a Hank stocking.
Don't make me cry.
Oh, I love it. It is perfect.
Y'all are something else. I didn't even see that.
I know you love stone. I really wanted a stone fireplace in here because it just makes it feel really cozy. Like, I can see you guys all here in the wintertime. And a stone fireplace just feels like the lake to me.
Yes. Yeah. I love this. This is beautiful.
That's white oak from our farm.
You'll have your stockings all here. We've got Hank's up.
Yes.
But you also have a place to store your stockings. This mantle can just roll out.
That is the coolest thing ever.
And you can store games, books, controllers.
That's such a surprise. My gosh.
Look at the panels on the wall.
What a perfect color. Love
this.
This is beautiful.
Yeah, so you have the wood again. We have the vertical nickel gap trim just to give some texture in here and to make it feel really cozy.
It's like a little tree house.
It is.
It is.
So then you've got the doors going out with, like, we went with the glass handrails with the black metal so you can just see right out to the lake. A new composite decking that you never have to mess with.
You are my favorite people in the whole world.
Okay, you want to check out behind here?
I do.
See what's back? Yeah. We did pocket doors to save space in the room and in the closet.
Oh my God.
Closet heaven.
You actually have room for all your
clothes. I have room for my sweaters and my shoes.
And you don't have to go to two separate closets to get it.
I love it.
One more space.
Bathroom.
One more door.
Another pocket door. Okay. Oh my gosh! Dream shower!
Oh my. You got your stone.
Pull that cabinet out. Even more storage.
Oh my gosh.
Yes.
Way to maximize the storage space.
I know you wanted a stone shower.
I love this. It'll be like taking a shower under a waterfall.
Kept the color consistent with the bedroom, and just these two spaces just tie really nicely together. And whenever the store is open, it just feels like an extension of this space as well.
Love it.
We got to go outside. We got to get downstairs and go outside.
All right,
let's go after you guys.
Oh my gosh.
Whoa.
This is awesome.
I will be spending all of my time right here.
Yes, you will.
Now you can actually use it.
Yes, because you couldn't before.
No.
What is this?
Oh my gosh.
And you never have to leave. You really never have to leave.
How many cold beers we can fit in there?
It gives you a little privacy, too, from the neighbors.
It
when you're
does.
Down here, you feel a little more tucked away. You can grill, have your stuff, come have your meal here.
And then go start a fire.
Walk down and sit at your fire pit. I know you said your boys sit around the fire
they
pit.
Do.
They do. I know this was important. So we terraced this out. So this space, I can just envision you guys sitting out here, looking out at the lake.
Look, it's amazing.
And there's shade with all the trees.
Yeah.
You have the new deck. So again, there's different levels, different spots where you can all be hanging out.